That's CrossFit. Give him a chair.
Sure in broad discovery,
Oh, what is the ice cream? Oh.
It's vanilla ice cream. I don't know.
Amazing.
How many
amazing. Amazing. It was really a pleasure to have you here. Great.
Same
for you.
Давайте, молодцы.
Ladies and gentlemen, we just witnessed history. This young man at age 60 completed 3,100 miles in 50 days, 15 hours, 6 minutes, and 4 seconds. He is the first man over 50 in world history to do this.
Wow.
Kilometers. He is setting UK records, world records for age group, all Scottish records, probably from beyond 1,000 miles up to 3,100, and he'll tiptoe the 5,000 kilometers for sure. He becomes a 28th all time, and just to give you some glimpse into what he did, On day 19, he was at the lowest ebb of his race. He was 71 miles behind pace. Yeah. So from day 19 to today, he averaged 63.908, and that includes one day where he did 49. It was a real hockey day. So it's an extraordinary comeback. We probably haven't seen this in the annals of the history of this race. And it's an extraordinary performance. And
yeah, he's a Scottish.
He's a Scottish. You just can't quantify how difficult this is. So it's an extraordinary record, one of the greatest records we've ever witnessed, one of the greatest comeback performances to one of the nicest competitors.
You want a free holiday.
Alan! Front and center, Alan! Alan! Alan, hurry up!
He's there, hiding behind.
Tell him what journey it takes to go from your home in Dundee, what you have to do to get to his place up in Orkney and Sandy.
He lives in a very small island in the northeast of Scotland, Sandy. He's got 535 normally population. There's been 534 for the last 50 days. But from my house, the last time I went with my partner around, I cycled 4 miles down to Dundee train station. I get the train up to Aberdeen, I get the night ferry to Kirkwall, I stay in a U-turn, I get the first ferry, goes by Edie, you get to Sandy. Now it's only about 12 miles long, he stays at 11.55 miles. It's got a total of 72 tarred roads. It's the how many times I've been there. So anyway, we cycle, there's a head on the rain, all the way up, didn't do it. It's part of your beam, it's 18, the kettles are cold.
This is a good one. If you want.
You can even sit if you want.
Well done, keep struggling. I'd just like to, first of all, thank the organisers for allowing me to take part. Because obviously that's the first thing. I first sort of made serious plans for this race about 18 months ago. Mainly for two reasons. I mean, I've been involved in ultra distance running for 20 years this year, that was one. Another one, obviously, I was 60 last October, and I wanted to do something a bit different from the normal races in 2014. And because I've always specialised in fixed distance and measures and timed races rather than trail ultras, obviously the longest run in the world had an appeal for me. I don't know why. So anyway, that was the background to it. That's why I'm here really. And I'm absolutely overjoyed that I managed to finish. Especially as you said, on day 19 or 20, we've got very, very long odds of getting to me standing here today. Yeah, it did take an inhuman effort trying to get claw those 70 miles back. And the way I did it was just trying to run the furthest I could every day. And I thought, well, there's nothing else I can do. If I do that, I've got a chance. And then as I sort of grew into the race, the distances went up and up. And I found I could keep on knocking out 63, 64, 65 miles, and then basically clawed my way back up there. Mm-hmm. But after that, it was an inhuman effort, really. But anyway, I'd just like to thank everyone involved in the race, obviously the organisers, the incredible lap counters. I've lost count of how many, nearly everyone seems to be a lap counter. obviously the kitchen staff, who we don't see much of, but obviously are working away just as long hours as we are. Really everyone involved in the race, the drivers, just who makes this incredible event work every year. I owe a debt of gratitude to both three of my handlers, Tim, Terry and Alan, especially Terry and Alan, because they did greatly extend their stays. They realised that I needed the support, and Alan obviously got the glory leg. obviously without them it wouldn't happen, to be honest. Because I just had to keep moving, sort of 18 hours a day. Yeah, that's it really. So thanks for having the opportunity, and I'm delighted to be the first person over 60 to do it. And I'm sure that other people will come forward now they know that. Well, I mean, I don't think it's anything to do with 60. If you're fit enough, you can do it, whether you're 60 or 70. But I think now that once it's been done once, it sort of gives other people ideas, and they think, oh, he's done it, and I beat him in such and such. maybe other people will give it a try, and I know some very good runners have tried it before, but something's gone wrong. And I'm sure other people will come out of the woodwork now and have a go. So it all expands sort of what's human performance and human possibilities, really. And I'm lucky enough to be the first. So I'm sure there'll be a second and a third. Thank you very much. Oh yeah, I wanted to say that. I'm very sorry. I hardly say anything when I'm running. I've hardly spoken for 7 weeks. mainly because for me to do what I do, I have to focus incredibly hard. It's just the way I do it. I don't listen to things, and I do this focusing, and I can't talk and focus at the same time. So people think I'm a very unfriendly bloke. Actually, I can be quite a nice fellow. I let Alan do the talking. It's just the way I have to operate. I can't do it chatting and listening to things. I need this iron will and iron focus, and that's just the way I have to do it. But I can start talking now.
You got 5,000 K?
Yeah, well, I can talk and I'll be that. But yeah, that's why I just have to. It's just I have to do this focusing, and even more so in an event which is the ideas, which is just so. I mean, this is the hardest thing I've ever done by 100, you know, as you could probably tell. Yeah, so that's it. I better stop talking.